Hi, friends. Namaste.
Namaste.
How are you today?
Special welcome today to the Russian Sangha, because we did earlier, we did a live chat with Sati and with the Moscow Russian Sangha, and invited them especially for tonight, so
the Russian,
Привет!
We have a Russian...
it's not Russian though.
Moscow, and I remember seeing so many people out of their seats all dancing together. That was a really, really great moment. It's actually, it's true, it's not Russian at all. We learned it from karaoke.
Yeah, it's a Hebrew chant.
It's a Hebrew, it's Hebrew. It's not even Brazilian Hebrew.
It's a Hebrew,
it must
song.
Be Hebrew. And it sounds
song,
Hebrew.
Yeah. But it's got too many words for us to, to learn them.
Ah, it's nice.
I was thinking this morning about using my voice and prayer and the difference between thinking a mantra and saying it out loud, and there's such a power in when we say things. There is, it has a very strong presence, and I never really understood, but our friend Ami, Mystic Goldsmith Ami, he could explain it really well to me. He said there is such a huge soup of thought energy in this, in us, in on the planet and around us, that to come up from that soup into another level, speech is stronger, you know, it lifts it out of that frequency of thought into this other frequency of speech, of actual sound, and it is really strong. To say a prayer out loud, especially also when it's in our own language, it's very revealing. It's very exposing. It feels very naked and very, very directed. Very. I think naked is the right word. So
it is naked, and I think that's a point for all of us here, and that is to be aware of the sound of our voice, to be aware of the quality of the voice. You know, when you hear yourself recorded back and you think, God, is that me? You know, It's just that we don't hear so much of our voices, and I think it's a really good meditation practice just to be aware of the way you sound in the atmosphere, in how your voice, if your voice is tense here, or if there's a tightness in the throat where we have this kind of sound. You know, we talk and it's a different quality, and there's something about speaking. It doesn't have to be, and sometimes you guys say you can't hear us, but it's necessary to have the voice that we are comfortable with, and not to forget that we are, every time we bring a thought out into the open, that we have a responsibility to share it in the most direct way, you know. Is that true?
Mm. And also, you know, with the mantras, it's...
I'll be right back. I'm just going to get a drink.
With the mantras, it's also so beautiful that we are all... I think I've said this recently already, but I'll just say it again, that we are all voicing our prayers in a way that goes beyond our concepts of what we are grateful for, or what we are maybe asking for. Often prayers are connected with things that we are asking for, but with the mantras, we are just, it's a direct connection to love, prem, or ananda, bliss, or Ganesh, you know, the revealing of possibilities. It's a true sound that has no, that is not stained by any concept, any kind of mind concept of what that is, and that's what makes it so universal, and we all get to speak the truth at the same time all together, which is also very rare, because usually somebody speaks and somebody else listens, but here we are all contributing the truth into the sound space, sound sphere all together. And just like yesterday, Viten said, let's, you know, hold each other's hands, or, you know, as we are sitting here together. I could feel it so strongly. And the same way, it's just also today, feel that how our voice, how my voice, how your voice fits into and blends into the voice of everyone that is singing with us. And to make that a beautiful sound, like the sound of an angel singing, you know? Let's imagine what would an angel sound like, and have that feeling of caress and love in the voice, and softness. No, I just didn't catch your name, but you just let your father lift his body today, so we are singing for your father as he makes his journey into the light, into the next phase. Good you're here with us now.
Okay, shall we begin?
Have we ever stopped?
So let's first close our eyes. As we go inside, having the experience of how our body feels on the inside. Is our spine straight? Let's straighten up our spine for the meditation. And just becoming aware of our body, however making it as comfortable as you like to be. When we straighten our spine, we relax our shoulders. Become in a state of relaxed awareness. And the gift that we give each other right now is the gift that as individuals we can all begin to slow down. Slow down. Slow down. take a deep breath.
And breathe out.
As we breathe out, we exhale love. And a deep breath. And exhale joy. And a deep breath. Compassion into the world, linking each other's hands in this meditation, taking each other by the hand all across the world. And reach out the mantra Om together with Deva, in rhythm with Deva. And then we will go into the Gayatri Mantra and then back into the Om Mantra at the end. So we'll just take a little moment to sit in the silence of our spaces, our candles, our sacred space, bringing our awareness to the sounds. And we have a little moment of silence before we begin the chant. The sounds around you.
Let's take a deep breath. Thank you.
Savitur varenyam Bhargo devasya dhimahi Diyo yona prachodayat Om Bhuvasva tat Savitur varenyam Bhargo devasya dhimahi Diyo yona prachodayat Savitur varenyam Bhargo devasya dhimahi Diyo yona
to close your eyes if you have them open and come home to your inner sanctuary. And if you raise your gaze behind your closed eyes up to your third eye, you will see the light of the Gayatri. Spirit of the river, I can hear you. I feel as if I'm deep inside your song. I see you laughing, intoxicated, dancing. Will you carry me with you when I'm gone? Spirit of the forest, I'll be with you. Travel far to be among your kind, and you've been teaching me how to live among your people, and I'm so far from the world I left behind. Ashes to ashes, sermons in stone, oh how time passes. We're here and then we're gone, and all that remains when we're free of our chains is the love we shared. Mother Earth, what can I give back to you as you carry me to my rest? I bow to the turning of your seasons as I lay my head ashes to ashes, sermons in stone, oh how time passes. We're here and then we're gone, and all that remains when we're free of our chains is the love we share. The love we share. When we're free of our chains, it's the love we share. It's called Ashes to Ashes, but it's supposed to be a happy song. Kind of a happy song.
Cicada likes it.
Oh my God, you guys, I hope you're doing okay. I'm feeling for you. And today on my morning walk, I forgot that I was walking in a jungle, that I was just unaware. And that's in this beautiful space where I have the freedom to do that, and I can't imagine what it's like for some of you. So I'm just sending you all my total respect and total appreciation and admiration for your amazingness that we are together like this. Thank you. We're going to keep doing this. Again, I must tell you that I spoke to Deva and said maybe we should have a one day where we have a break, you know? Maybe we do, I don't know, but right now my feeling is, and I know it's Deva's too, right? Is that we continue to share these sacred moments with you. Shall we sing another mantra?
Actually, we have to go. Tomorrow, I'll just while I remember, tomorrow we're going to be live twice, and one time
busy.
One time 4 hours earlier than our usual session, so 4 hours earlier starting, with Brandon Bays and Kevin Billett, our beautiful beloved friends for 20 years now. Brandon and Kevin both do amazing good work, and they really they're really pouring their hearts out with meditations and programs that help help you in this situation.
I would even say transform the way you see life. I think that's the key for me with Brandon Bay's work. She has the potential to, the possibility to transform lives. And so we're very honored to be able to talk with her tomorrow, and Kevin, her beloved. That would be a nice thing. We'll bring the guitar. We'll be here, actually. I think we won't be going very far.
So that's tomorrow our morning, 4 hours earlier, and then our daily meditation.
Which means in Costa Rica time, it will be at
10 a.m.
10 a.m. tomorrow morning.
9 a.m. L.A. and 6 p.m. Europe, most of Europe.
What do you want to sing? You can sing Loka if you want, the whole thing. Yes. Oh, Mula Mantra.
Loka,
I say. What people of us or they say? It's a, whichever one you want. This was composed by our friend Michael Dawn down in Perth in Australia. And Michael, you might even be listening right now. If you are, we send you all our love. Also to Rob Stevenson and Ange down there, other musicians who play beautiful mantras and support their communities. This is Loka Samasta.
May all beings be happy. May all beings be free. May all my thoughts, words, and actions contribute in some way to the happiness. Sukino bhavantu, loka samasta.
Namaste, friends.
Namaste, thank you so much.